Hello everybody, today we will have a closer look at a knife from Mcusta, the really good quality Japanese company, actually a model from their limited edition custom series. Before I open this box, unlike my older knife reviews, I have to show a book. This is a portrait of Basho, famous Japanese haiku poet from the 17th century, and his most famous haiku is about a frog, and it goes like this. Well, there are actually many translations for that haiku. The old pond, a frog jumps in, splash. Well, actually that poem is so I would say popular and famous in Japan that there's even a book written only about that haiku. The old pond is something that stands a bit on its own. It has also, if you know Japanese, the way this is written, it reinforces the fact that this is like an eternity. Then the frog jumps in, that's something that happens, and splash, the result, the creation, you could say, which is also in Japanese a bit like a word that makes a bit the sounds of a splash. But I will not analyze this further, but it's interesting for you to know that this is a very famous poem. So I'm not now going back to the knife in question. So it comes in a handsome compact box. I already unwrapped the knife from the plastic sleeve. There is, like some other classic Mcustas, there is a rather amusingly colored pouch, which really refers also to the ancient Japanese tradition, you could say, of the samurai katanas, for example. Well, I think it's quite amusing. Now, before I open the knife, have a closer look at the handle. And indeed, this is an illustration of that famous haiku. You see here the frog and the pond where there are some lines here that illustrates the splashing. So I think it's actually purely graphically, even without knowing that there is a famous haiku behind it, I think it's still very beautifully and tastefully done. Not overdone, like sometimes custom knives are, that I think that there's too much. So it's very nicely inlaid, the frog, as you could see, from steel. This is, I'm not certain which kind, I think turquoise or kind of a semi-gem, actually, gemstone, very carefully laid in. Also carefully the metal leaf, literally, here really adds to the glass. And at the other side, so it is really a gentleman kind of knife, there's no clip, you have actually the same illustration, more or less in a symmetric way. Otherwise, the handle wood is cocobolo. So you may know perhaps that Mcusta, if you know them, and if you have them, you probably know that they are really good quality. Actually, this one I discussed that previously. It's one of their popular classic ones. The Take is a wonderful knife at a good price, and really well made. Also a bit small. Well, for gentleman use is perfectly okay. Actually, the limited, I will now open it, is a bit bigger. So the limited, the blade is around 8 centimeters long, while the many Mcustas have a blade that's around 7 centimeters long. Let me double check. Well, what do I know? It's even 8.5 centimeters long, the blade. So which makes it That bit of extra size, I think it really adds to the class and the usability of this knife. Because yes, I intend to use it, it's not just a display model. I come back here to this one, the new custom, you could say, one. I think also it is even nicer finished than the one that you just saw, than the other Mcustas. Everything is very nicely rounded. You have truly a feel of precision. The blade here is rounded at the top, roughly 2.5 millimeter, I think. It's a bit difficult to see because of the, no, it's 3 actually, typical pocket knife thickness. And it is It is a Damascus blade in the Mcusta style. Actually, you have in fact a VG10 core, and then at every side, I think around 16 layers of lower end steel, but which adds, you could say, some elasticity, and then it's actually ground into the blade shape. So it's not exactly the same as a classic kind of Damascus with folding over and over. No, this is really a more laminated kind of Damascus, but it looks pretty well. I think that my camera doesn't pick up the Damascus lines as well as on the older as the other Mcusta that I have. One of the advantages here is this is truly rust resistant, which with many classical Damascuses, they are more carbon steel based, so I'm always afraid to use them on fruit, for example, unless you go for the powder Damascuses. But okay, so this one is a layered Damascus, as all Mcustas, exceedingly sharp. Yes, so around 110 grams, I would say. It also exists, by the way, in a non-Damascus version for something like $30 less, I think. So, which is also very beautiful in its own. But I think for this kind of knife, Damascus is okay. And it is, I think you agree that as a whole, it's not overdone here. It's not too heavy, the look and feel of it, which you sometimes have with custom limited illustrated designs. I think this is still in very good taste. Well, and in fact, being inspired by a haiku, I think it's very zen. It's in very good taste itself. It's like all my Mcustas that I know of, a liner lock with not really a thick liner. It's around a millimeter, but it, so which means that's not really an issue. It's just 1 millimeter. Some heavy use knives have thicker liner locks or frame locks. This is truly meant purely for cutting, and in that concept it will work for a long time because there is nothing wrong with the construction quality. It's solidly made. You can adjust the pivot if you want, but there is no play on it. But there's a tiny bit of elasticity, you could say, but which is normal. It's not the same as it's not the same as play. And so yes, nicely rounded here. Still at the inside, I have the impression it's still an edge, but it's quite okay actually. You won't cut yourself. I have a few knives, and I think in fact my other one here, this one, is a bit sharper at the inside. Not really to worry about, but this one is a bit smoother there. And so yes, wonderful, wonderfully elegant knife. I think an excellent alternative to, let's say, a William Henry knife. I think this one looks better and is in essence in the same class. VG10 is a really good steel as well, we all know that. Yeah, lovely made. It opens truly smoothly, which it should at the price. So indeed, if I now have a closer look at the price of the thing, how much is this cost? Well, in essence, exactly the same as a small Sebenza. So, it depends on what your interests are and who you are, whether this is a knife for you or a Sebenza, a small Sebenza knife for you. Small Sebenza is an extremely good, low tolerance, heavy duty folder. So, if you are really into heavy duty usage, you should definitely go for the Sebenza. Also the frame lock that it has is intrinsically, is by the essence of it, is hyper reliable. This one is more for me. This is more my choice. I like something elegant that is still very capable. This is, I would say, more for somebody would otherwise buy a Klotzli knife, which I also love a lot. So it's more elegant than heavy. Not done for heavy use, but strong enough. If you for normal cutting, it will last you a very long time and with a really, really good style. So, I hope you found this interesting. A kind of custom knife, a small series, I think 50 of them were made, or 50 or 100, I forgot. Relatively small series of these knives. So, and also this pattern does not come back in their normal production knives, because they are usually always a bit smaller than Mcusta. So truly recommended actually. It's really on a very high level. So I hope you found this interesting, a bit of poetic introduction, why not. Feel free to leave feedback.